Welcome to today's video in scientific programming in Python. And in this week we will introduce to you several plotting libraries, actually a lot of them. And I'm going to show the code for them, but I'm not expecting you, except the first one, ggplot, to memorize the code and use it. I just want to show it to you such that you've seen all of them, and if you need them or think it may be useful to use them, to simply Google them and figure it out for yourself. And so this is beyond matplotlib. So why, after having shown matplotlib already, are we showing you more plotting libraries now? Well, matplotlib is great and stays probably for quite some time the plotting library of choice. However, there are situations where matplotlib is annoying, and that's because matplotlib takes quite some lines to get pretty and takes some looping and all that stuff, which you may not always want. And there are libraries which are awesome at making, for example, interactive plots, which is, I think, impossible in matplotlib. There are libraries that allow you to easily and quickly create plots with one command, which is really, really nice. Don't have to loop over stuff, you just call plot and you're done. And so there are libraries where you can easily add statistics to your plot. So you already have a box plot and you additionally want to show, or you want to exchange the box plot for a violin plot, or you want to additionally show the data distribution or something. That's where other libraries are really useful, because doing this in matplotlib is a lot of code, and this is especially for exploratory data analysis. This is what we're looking for here. So you have your data, you don't know about it, and because humans are good at interpreting visual information, you provide the visual information for yourself or for your supervisor or whoever is seeing the data, such that it's easy and quick to see if there are correlations or if there's anything important in the data. So I want to quickly iterate over many plots, and for that there are libraries which create plots much faster and also much prettier than matplotlib. Okay, first of all, make sure to install the requirements. So I have a requirements.txt file here, because for some libraries they weren't in the environment.yaml file, so you have to install them using pip install minus r requirements, and some are really, really new. So for example, plotly here, I have all the tabs open with it, has now possibility to natively plot using, so you can change in pandas. Philip showed you pandas plotting last week, and you can call the pandas.plot function method with the backend of plotly, which makes the plots automatically interactive, and that feature is like 2 weeks old. So make sure to install the newest libraries. All right, so let me first show you these libraries before we get back to the wet thread. Our progress so far inside the lecture in general, and then I'm going to ggplot in detail. Then I'm going to go quick over a few others, and then I'm going to show Altair again in a bit more detail, because I really like those two libraries. Alright, so we're working with this dataset mostly. Vega datasets is a library that provides some datasets to work with, and we see that we have the cars dataset here. And this has a few lines. It's a standard pandas data frame. And we also sometimes work with the Titanic dataset, which, well, this here is simply about cars, and this here is about the survivors or non-survivors of the Titanic. Okay, and just as a teaser, so for example, Seaborn is really nice, because Seaborn has, for example, the pair plot, which in one line of code generates you all of these plots which pair to variables. So we see miles per gallon against cylinders, for example, for the cars. And we see if they are, so obviously, so we see correlations here between horsepower and displacement. There's a clear correlation, or displacement and, well, that's horsepower again, or displacement again, the weight. We see correlations in there. So if you want to see quick correlations in your data, one variable against the other, Seaborn pair plot, one line of code, accept the setup, really nice. Plotline is nice because it follows the grammar of graphics, which I'm going to explain to you in a second, and you can simply add components by stating their names. So we want to have a violin plot here, and we additionally want to show the summary. And if I also wanted to show a jitter plot in there, could simply additionally add the jitter plot to it, and if I think this is too much for me, I simply comment out the line where that happens. Interactive plots are really quickly done in Plotly. So this here is simply not even the quickest way of to do that, but an example plot, and in Plotly I can, for example, automatically zoom in here. And this also becomes an HTML right away. And I can, it's even interactive inside the HTML. And then there's Altair, and Altair is really nice because this is how to really make nice interactive plots. So here, those two plots, as you see, are connected. I can select, for example, that I only want to look at this data. And here, for example, I quickly see that, well, of the cars with low miles per gallon, most of them are American, which is probably not new, but they also have more horsepower, as we see here. And also we're looking at Jupyter widgets, which provide another way of inputting, and we can thus have interactive plots. So we can, for example, here set an age range for the sex distribution of our Titanic data set. So we see that in this age group, there were mostly females, no, mostly males, and in other age groups, the distribution of females was higher. Okay, so this is a teaser, and then I'm going to show you them in a bit more detail below.